What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Classic Octane. I am Taylor. So today I'm trying out something a little bit differently. So during the week, I am basically 100% focused on customer projects. So earlier this week, you saw me do a Willett run on this CB550 build we just started. I picked up the Midnight Blue CB550 we built a couple of months ago for the next round of kind of modifications and, you know, kind of doing round two on this bike. And I am in the process of making a video to show you guys all of that. We also had another bike get dropped off this week, which is gonna be, you guessed it, a CB550 build, kind of Classic Octane special. Customer already had the tough side seat and everything. Believe it or not, this guy trailered this bike down from Pennsylvania all the way to Texas for me to build it. So that's kind of, it's awesome. I'm really kind of humbled that somebody would be willing to drive that far just for me to work on their bike. So he dropped this off. We're gonna have it for a month or so. He's gonna drive back down and pick it up. But that's not the purpose of this video. The purpose of this video is for me to start to work on my own projects as well. So I figured if I'm doing customer builds on the weekdays, maybe on the weekend, I can, you know, carve out part of a day to work on my own project. So I have a couple of my own personal bikes, and I also have cars and stuff I'm working on as well. So that's what today's gonna be. It's gonna be working on one of my projects. So the project we're going to be working on today is my 69 Camaro. So if you're not familiar with this car, I bought it a number of years ago. I have quite a few videos on the channel. I will throw a link to the whole playlist. But basically, I bought it as a recently painted shell, no interior, small block with an automatic, 10-bolt rear, four-wheel drum brakes, all-stock suspension. Since then, we've done kind of a, I guess you can consider it a pro touring kind of build. We have all modern, like tubular upper and lower control arms, coilovers, four-wheel disc brakes. We did a complete interior with Pro Car seats, suede headliner, lizard skin, the whole inside. The interior is probably, I would say 90% done. Still need to figure out like a console and proper modern gauges and a stereo and all that kind of stuff, but we'll worry about that a little bit later on. To make the car actually run and drive well, we have done a complete drivetrain swap. So that's what that yellow GTO is doing out there. That was the donor car for my LS with a T56. We have a super strong drive shaft down to a built 9-inch. I kind of set up the whole drivetrain of the car to handle way more power than it actually makes. I did like a billet center section and everything in the 9-inch. So that's capable of 1400 horsepower, no problem. It's got a spec twin disc clutch in it that's capable of well over 1200 horsepower. Then the engine itself, I put a turbo friendly cam. So it's a decent cam when the engine's kind of naturally aspirated. It's got a nice lope to it and stuff you'll hear later in the video, but it is really designed to kind of wake up when it's in a turbo application. So everything else I've done, I have like the Holley oil pan that's got the turbo drains and everything built into it. So the engine and everything is set up for being turboed, which is the plan somewhat down the road. So this is kind of where we're at right now. I'm still finalizing my tune. This is the first car I've ever tried to tune myself. So it's taking a little bit of learning to get us down the road. But my biggest issue is what we're going to address today, and that's with my rear suspension and some rubbing with our tires. So when I first put these wheels and tires on here, I didn't have any rubbing issues. These are 18 by 10s, maybe 10 and a half, with a 275/35/18 tire. You can fit that on a stock 69 Camaro without having to go mini tubs or anything. Where I ran into issues is when I swapped the 9-inch in, it was just a little bit like more narrow than the 10-bolt was, and it caused some clearance issues with our shock mounts. So let me see if I can climb under here and show you. So if you can see how close our lower shock mount is to the wheel, when I originally put that on there, the shock mount hit the inside lip of the rim. And obviously we can't run like that, so I had to put a very small spacer. If you can see it in there, it's probably a quarter of an inch. It's not a huge spacer, it's just enough to give me the clearance I needed. But because I matched our wheel offset to fit a kind of stock 10-bolt or 12-bolt, We have just a little bit of clearance issues now with our inside lip of the fender. I have rolled these fenders, but on a decent sized bump or on really heavy acceleration, it squats just enough to start to get some tire rubbing. So what I want to do today is I'm actually going to remove one of the kind of rubber mounts on in between our leaf spring and the actual mount itself to try and give us like maybe a quarter of an inch, a little bit higher ride height in the back here, which is welcomed because this car is so low to the ground. I don't know if you can see the scrape marks on my garage floor, but it actually scrapes a little bit when I pull in and out of the garage. So I think a little bit additional clearance back here is gonna be a good thing. So before we modify this, I'm curious what our stock kind of ground to fender distance is so we can see how much this actually raises the back. We are 23, a little over 23 and a half, 23 and 5/8, looks like. Yeah, I'm gonna call it 23 and 5/8. So let's go ahead and jack the back of this up, put it on some jack stands. We're gonna undo those leaf springs, pull out the rubber isolator from, I guess it would be the bottom, to try and just increase that a little bit, see if we can't get a quarter, I would love about a half inch higher on the back. If that doesn't work, we might have to look into maybe extended shackles, something like that, because we're actually running 3-inch drop springs in the back right now, and obviously that's proving to be just a little bit too much. Well, I got one side done, no problem, but in typical working on a car fashion, it seems like these things just try and fight you sometimes. The U-bolt on one side just snapped in half. The bolt was coming all the way out, no problem. The last, like, eighth of an inch, it just got caught and then started to bend it and literally just snapped the U-bolt. So I don't think these were super high quality U-bolts anyway. Luckily, the Napa Auto Parts around the corner from my house has the exact same size in stock. So I'm gonna go run over there and do a little curbside pickup, get one, and then we'll throw this thing back together, put it on the ground, see if we improved our ride height at all. Just put it down on the ground and to my naked eye, it looks exactly the same. what was our measurement? 23 and 5/8. We are at 23 and 3/4. Yeah, that's not gonna be enough. I'm looking for more like, honestly, probably more like 24 and a half. I'd like to go at least another half inch higher. That'll actually make it match the front stance as well. I have the front set a little bit high on the adjustable coilovers because I want this car to be drivable. I don't want to be, you know, sticking my exhaust on speed bumps or having to go super slow in and out of parking lots. I'd rather be up a little bit higher and be drivable. So unfortunately, that's not going to be enough for us. So I think my next option is the shackles and the leaf springs. I think I want to get a little bit longer ones. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So hopefully you guys can see what I'm looking at here, but basically this is how the leaf springs are mounted. There's a bushing that goes through the frame, that there's a bolt that goes through that, and then right here there's a bushing and the leaf spring that the bolt goes through. So it has these metal, just basically a flat bar with holes on either side. So I'm thinking they sell adjustable ones of these. If I can order one that has, you know, a number of holes, is a little bit longer and has a couple of different holes, maybe every half inch or so, we can start to kind of move the bolt down one notch at a time until we reach our kind of desired ride height, and then I can trim off, you know, the remaining holes. So that's what I'm thinking I'm gonna do now. I can't find any of those locally, so I'm gonna have to order it. So this video is gonna have to kind of go on pause until those come in, but that's our next step so we can lift this thing up a little bit. It's now the next weekend. We're back on the Camaro project. I do have my new shackles in, so I have four of these plates. I could have made these, but they're only like 12 or 13 bucks on Summit, so I just went ahead and ordered them. It looks like if we use this top hole for the bolt that's through the frame, somewhere around maybe the center one is going to be what we're going to be shooting for, or possibly the one right below that. Once we actually figure out exactly which hole we're going to use and everything's finalized, I'll probably trim off the excess just so there's not like a big 2-inch bar kind of hanging below the back of the car. So what do you say we jack this thing up, swap out these plates, and see how much lift we get in the rear? So I got one side out. Now I'm kind of comparing the two. So if we line these up, this other hole kind of falls right in between these two. So if I put it on this one, it'll be about a half inch higher. I'm trying to decide if I want to just go all out and go all the way to this hole, just to know that I'm only going to have to do this once, and the back might be just a little bit higher than I want it to be. I think that's what I'm going to do, because I don't really want to have to take these back out again, and I think I'm going to need a little bit more clearance. So I'd rather have like more than enough than just barely enough, if that makes sense. So I'm going to go down to this hole. I am going to have to enlarge this just a little bit because our bolt doesn't quite fit through. So I'll take this over to the drill press, enlarge this hole and enlarge that one, and then we'll put them both on the car. So I figured, since you guys actually haven't seen me use the mill yet, we'll use the mill for this operation. So I need to switch this out to a 5/8 collet. We already had a 5/8 collet in there, so I don't actually need this one. The closest drill size I could find in my hoard is a 39/64. That should be pretty good. I'm actually going to use the old ones as parallels because I don't have any, which is not super accurate, but these holes don't need to be perfect. We'll put them in there like that, take our piece. Should we get enough clearance? I want to be able to drill kind of both holes without hitting anything. Give the vise a nice little tighten down. And we are good to go. I'm just going to kind of eyeball it to get it into place here. Raise our knee up. All right, that should be up almost enough. So first hole, come on this side so you can see what I'm doing. I said I'm just going to eyeball this because it doesn't need to be perfect. They make tools to find the center of these, but since I'm very new to milling, I don't actually have any of those tools yet. That seems like it'll work for us right there. Okay. See how she does. It's nice and even. Easy enough. Now we'll come down to this hole. So I can just leave my Y-axis alone. Just come all the way down here. Maybe I won't be able to leave my Y-axis alone. I have not actually like trammed in this mill at all, meaning it's like this vise is not even perfectly parallel with the machine. So this is basically just a big glorified drill press at the moment, which is fine. Yep. that's it. So I'll go ahead and run a little thing on around here to deburr our holes, but go ahead and repeat that operation 3 more times. Okay, moment of truth. Let's see how much higher it is. Hopefully it doesn't look like a 70s dragster or something. Okay. Definitely noticeably higher. Let's see if we can settle it. We were at 23¾. We are now at 24¼. So that means with removing that first part, the rubber isolator, and then now the longer shackles, we've raised it a total of, what, 3/4 of an inch? I don't remember exactly what we started at, but the shackles alone raised it a little over 1/2 of an inch. What do you say we fire it up and maybe we'll take it for a quick spin, see if there's any improvement? It's been, I don't even know, at least a couple of months since I've started this thing, so it could prove to be very grumpy, but we'll find out. Pretty well. It was a little bit too low in the back before, but all right, I'll hook you guys up on the windshield and we'll go for a test drive. Yeah, I have no idea if you guys are going to be able to hear me or not, but so far so good. A couple miles in, I'm taking it on the little back road that I always take my motorcycles on, and I haven't had any rubbing yet, but this road will be a good test. Needs a pro.
driving a little bit, and I'll fill you guys in if anything changes. So far, so good.
That was a very, very successful test drive. I am ecstatic that it went that well. The only time we got the car to scrape was under that really heavy bump. You know, it was probably going 50, 55 miles an hour in a big dip, like, you know, into a little kind of creek crossing. And if that's the only time the car rubs compared to what it had before, that is a massive improvement. I also don't think we've hurt the looks at all. If anything, I think we may have improved it now that it's kind of perfectly level, the stance is, when before the back end was a little bit lower than the front. So if you look at the back tire, we can almost see the top of the tire, but not quite. And then in the front, same deal, almost see the top of the tire, but can't. So nice level stance. I still have some adjustability should I decide to do that, but I think we're ready to move on to continuing to tune this thing. And then the next major project is I need to put my subframe connectors on. I still haven't done those. They're just sitting in my attic. So we'll pull those down. I'm going to have to, I think, tweak the subframe a little bit because I think my subframe is just a little bit crooked. There's like a couple of degrees of adjustment, and I think mine is off just a little bit, which is part of the reason why I haven't gotten a full alignment yet, is I want to fix that and then put the subframe connectors on, then go get a professional alignment. But that's where I'm going to call it on this one, guys. I appreciate you watching. I know some of you guys aren't really into classic car content, but the Camaro is, you know, near and dear to my heart, and I wanted to work on it on my weekends or my personal time. So I'm going to go ahead and give this thing a wash because it is completely disgusting. And then, yeah, we'll be back sometime in the next couple of weeks for the next round of upgrades. So let me know what you guys think about this. If you guys are doing an LS swap or anything like that, feel free to drop questions below. I will try to help as much as I can, and I'll see you guys on the next one.